Hip arthroscopy is a newer treatment option that allows us to address hip impingement and labral tears about the hip with minimally invasive techniques. Our understanding of hip impingement and hip injuries around athletes has evolved tremendously over the last few years. And with this increased understanding, we're able to treat these injuries much better and get our athletes back to play sooner. The hip is a ball and socket joint, and sometimes with hip impingement, you can have different areas of bony growth that causes the hip to actually pinch, especially when the hip moves up in flexion and when the hip comes across the body. These areas of bony overgrowth occur over here on the femoral neck or over here on the rim of the acetabulum or the socket side of the hip. When they start to pinch, when the hip moves up, the thing that gets pinched is the labrum, which sits as an O-ring on the socket side of the hip joint. If it pinches enough, sometimes the labrum can tear, and that can cause some pain inside the front of the hip joint, and pain with activities such as running or cycling, and sometimes cause some clicking and popping around the hip joint. Previously, hip impingement used to be treated with a big surgery and a hip dislocation, which involved a pretty extensive recovery. With the advent of hip arthroscopy, we can do this procedure in a much less invasive way. It spares the muscles and the hip joint and vastly speeds up the recovery. It's a minimally invasive procedure that's usually done as an outpatient procedure. What we do is we make three small portals. They're about less than a centimeter in size each, and we access the hip joint. We address the areas of bony abnormalities that are causing the hip pinching, and we repair the labrum back down with suture anchors. It's usually done as an outpatient procedure, and most patients come and go the same day. The recovery involves using a brace for about 6 weeks after surgery, physical therapy for usually 2 to 3 months. The total recovery time before returning to sports is anywhere between 3 and 6 months. One of the things I love about this procedure is when I see someone who's been struggling with their hip pain for years, who hasn't been able to cycle or hasn't been able to run, which is something they would love to do. And after the surgery, when they come back and tell me that they're back to running or back to cycling, it's very satisfying and it really makes my day.